Papa, my name is Brendan Meyers. This is the 30 for 30 training, completely free, workout series, and let's jump right in. They got problems on problems on problems on problems on problems on problems. I solve them, I run through the money, depression be calling. Left on my blessings, I feel like I'm falling. The birdie is back, tell me I'm garbage. I'm going through something, that's why I ain't calling. Phone and progression, it's all that I wanted. All right, so 30 for 30, what the heck does it mean? Just every single morning at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, we are releasing a new workout video. It's absolutely free. You can follow it at your house or even at the park. Now today, we have legs. It's gonna burn, and before every single exercise, we always show you the specific muscles that will be worked. Now before we jump into the actual workout, I wanna show you a few tips you could be following to get started right now. All right, quick tip number one. If you're more advanced, I suggest slowing down all reps for this workout. Slow and controlled wins. Number two, my favorite cereal to consume during my bulk is Ezekiel Raisin Bran. Try it for yourself. Number three, one of the best vegetables to consume in your diet is cucumbers. They are rich in things like vitamin K, vitamin C, and potassium. Number four, you may get your cardio in after leg days just like me. I prefer more HIIT style, but that's always up to you. And last but not least, number five, every morning I take my greens with creatine, vitamin B12, vitamin C, magnesium, and vitamin D. You can pick yours up. The link is in the description. All right, first movement, we're gonna be following a suicide squat, but on the wall. So you want everything to be completely up against the wall, tucking your chin so everything's straight, neutral spine as you can see. I'm not here, I'm not rounding my back, I'm tightening everything into the wall. Again, my feet are gonna be just within shoulder width apart, right? You're gonna be on the balls of your feet for this movement. So what I want you to do is drag down as your knees come forward, squeezing your abs as much as possible so they're coming into the wall, all right? Stabilize, stabilize, stabilize here. Once you come here, pause for 2 seconds, then it's coming up slow and controlled. Again, watch very, very closely. I'm on the balls of my feet, I'm coming down. I'm not on my toes here, I'm on the balls of my feet, a very strong position here, all right? And I'm coming down, 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 allowing my knees to go forward, pausing here for 2 seconds, and then we're coming straight back up. If your knees are hurting you, just do a wall sit. Do not try and just like prove to yourself that you can do whatever. This is not that type of an exercise. Egos do not win you a physique. All right, so we have split squats going into Bulgarian split squat pulsators. So with these split squats, we wanna make sure that our hip flexor, I say this in every single video, is not fully stretching, and then we're also not externally rotating at our hip, okay? We also don't wanna have it too far out, because again, your hip flexor will be stretching. If you feel any strain here, you're probably not doing it correctly, all right? The other thing that I want you to focus on is making sure that your foot is not internally rotated, or really your hip, or externally rotated with that lead foot, all right? Now, from this position, you're just gonna come, stand up straight, everything completely straight, neutral spine, chin tucked right here. You're gonna take one step out, okay? From this position, I want you to think about loading your hip into your body. So load, notice how I just shifted back. You're gonna feel a lot of contraction going into your glute at that position, right? Now all you're gonna do is come straight down, and straight back up, okay? Now make sure you're not fully extending that knee. We don't want that. We just want you to come straight down and straight up, okay? Then we're gonna move straight into these Bulgarian split squat pulsators. So our foot, you'll notice, is at the tip. It's about our toes, or just above our toes on those bones that are right above, all right? And then our foot, again, we don't want it to be too far out because we're gonna stretch this hip flexor, so we're gonna come back a little bit, all right? Make sure that this knee is dropping and not working that much. All right, this is more stabilization. This left leg, again, you're going to load it. Boom, you see that positioning? It's not here, it's not externally rotating at the hip, it's here, load it. So we're gonna come down right here about halfway, and then we're gonna be pulsating up and down. This is not like a crazy, huge movement. It's here and very, very small, up and down. Really, really feel that burn, and don't go too low in that movement, and that is your superset. Okay, here we go. Jump squats going into 20 second hamstring holds. This is a superset. All right, so these jump squats, we're gonna be just outside of shoulder width apart. Really find a comfortable, comfortable position. If you feel like you're a little bit more comfortable here and you have a little bit more mobility, that's completely fine as well. But I'm gonna be in this position, all right? Now, you're gonna see me, because of my mobility in my ankles and also in a certain part of my spine, I have herniations right now, I'm not gonna be able to get all the way down to parallel and be in the right positioning with my chest. But I want you to try and stay as straight as possible with your spine, all right? So here, all right, you can actually start here, this is completely fine. And now from this position, it's a jump squat. So you're gonna be here, load in this position, keep your chin tucked, think about you're going up, triple extension from your hip to your knee, to your ankle, all the way up, boom, and then pause in that position again, okay? Now you notice I just went back a little bit. That's completely fine, I like fell back slightly. That's okay, we really wanna get as high as possible with these jump squats. If you have knee problems, then just go ahead and relax a little bit and don't even worry about doing this movement. Maybe you can just do regular squats and that'll be better. And then we're gonna move into the hamstring holds. We're gonna be on our back. All right, you can have socks on if you'd like. Sometimes I like to use socks, sometimes I don't. Place my heels on the ground here, just within shoulder width apart. That's very, very important. You can even go all the way to your feet close together, but keeping your knees slightly outside. There's a little space right here, as you can see. All right, from this position, keep everything tucked, all right? We're gonna come up. Now notice my glutes are squeezing into each other and they're away from the ground. There's a space right below me, you see this? But I'm not overextending my low back. That's not what I'm doing. I'm squeezing everything in and I'm just lifting my glutes away from the ground. Now, I'm gonna come up slightly until I start feeling my hamstrings burning like crazy, all right? You don't wanna point your toes. It's gonna take a lot of retraction off of these hamstrings, or contraction from these hamstrings. We want to load your toes almost like they're coming towards your head, all right? And squeeze in this position and push into the ground as much as you can, as if you're trying to pull while you're holding that position, and that is your superset. Okay, so we have 8 counter adductions going into a 30-second glute hold. All right, so adductions, what you're gonna do, you're not gonna go on a full split unless you wanna tear everything in your groins and your adductors. We don't want that, all right? But we are gonna wear some socks. Look at my socks. I have a couple of holes at the bottom of them, but do not make fun of me, that's not cool. From this position, we are going to have our hands right here on the table, that's completely fine. You want a lower table if possible, all right? Now, we don't wanna push too much off the table, it's just to allow ourselves to really utilize the adduction phase of this movement, all right? So from this position, we're gonna lift ourselves as we are pulling into our inner legs all the way to the top and squeezing as much as possible at the top and then resetting, okay? Now watch very, very closely. My chin was dropping a little bit more. That's on purpose. I'm showing you so that you don't do it, okay? So instead of being here, I want you to come back and squeeze everything up. Stay as upright as possible and bend at your hips slightly. That's all I want, all right? From this position, again, you're going to squeeze as much as you can while lifting up with your hands slightly. You're gonna feel in your adductors like crazy, all the way up. Squeeze, 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 and reset. Jeez, okay, I really don't like that. Then we're gonna go into a glute bridge and really squeeze those glutes here, okay? Our feet are gonna be just outside of shoulder width apart, not here, a little bit further, instead of shoulder width apart, we're really trying to isolate those glutes as much as we can, okay? Keep chin tucked, squeezing our abs all the way in. Notice how I'm not here, I'm here, okay? And I'm gonna come up. Now look at this part. I'm not here, I am squeezing just through my glutes, all the way up, so I feel my glutes, and correction, you're not only gonna feel your glutes, you're also gonna be feeling your hamstrings, and that's my apology on misguiding you. Okay, from this position, you're just gonna squeeze as much as possible and hold. Now, a lot of people are just going to hold. We don't want that. We want you to squeeze and hold at the same time. So try and contract your muscles for the 30 seconds, and you'll feel really good after that superset. Okay, we're finishing off with 1-minute pistol squat pulsators. Absolutely brutal. You're gonna be feeling it for sure after this one. Okay, so if you watch all the other videos, what we do to get in the right positioning in this assisted pistol squat hold position is we come in a circle with our right leg, okay? Now notice how I'm almost internally rotating with this outside hip, okay? This is gonna put me back into this position and allow me to sit into that glute. You wanna feel it in your glute like crazy, not so much here. If you're doing it here, you're not working the right muscle and you're not in the right positioning, so sit back. The more you sit down, you're gonna feel a little bit more. You don't wanna go too far down though. We don't wanna go 90-degree angle. From this position, you can have your toe on the ground if you would like, absolutely no worries, but you're around your upper back, and from here, you're just gonna go up and down. Notice how I'm going up and down, I'm squeezing all the way through, not only my toes, but from my heel to the toe, okay? Just coming up and down, and you will be feeling it. It's not supposed to be so quick, okay? It's supposed to be up and down, a controlled movement for 1 minute straight. Now, if you feel like you're all the way out here, you're not doing it correctly. If you feel like you're trying to internally rotate, you're not doing it correctly. So just make sure you're stabilizing correctly, coming up and down very slowly, and that is and concluding your workout. All right, so there you have it. That is your workout for the day, 30 for 30. Absolutely love these workouts. We're doing it for 30 days, so jump right in. Let me know, give me your feedback. Today was legs, we're gonna come back tomorrow. I don't know exactly what we're doing, but one thing I'll tell you is that if you're eating correctly, you can 100% not only sustain the muscles that you've built in the gym, but you can also build some muscle if you're doing these exercises properly. And also, if you're not crazy advanced and you're used to doing crazy pull-ups and a lot of resistance training and all that stuff, you definitely can build muscle. And trust yourself, trust the process. If you aren't sleeping right, if you're not drinking enough water, if you don't have electrolytes, if you're not doing all these different things, if you're not doing a little bit of cardio, you could see a difference in what you actually want with your physique. So just keep these things in mind. Now, create your nutrition. The low stim pre-workout is launching April 27th. I'm super excited. That's Monday at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'm gonna put the link in the description so that you can come back to this video or other videos, whatever. We're also on Facebook. Check those out there. I'm Brennan. Check out my Instagram right here. Subscribe if you haven't already. Turn your post notifications on. We'll see you 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Yeah. Bye. See you next time.